This story begins with one ordinary hit.
It knocked the wind out of me, so at first I just figured no big deal. And then 2 days later, I woke up with chest pains.
Harlem senior Alex Salisbury stands on the sidelines and remembers what happened next. He remembers the routine exams that turned into blood tests, and the blood tests that turned into a bone marrow test, and then the diagnosis.
They came back and told me I had AML leukemia.
The news struck Alex harder than any impact he'd ever felt. He suddenly went from an active three-sport athlete to a spectator. But it was there he found out just how much he meant to the Huskies.
Alex is a little bit of extra motivation when we're slumping a little bit, getting tired. So we want to win it for him, and we kind of dedicated our season to Alex.
We finish every practice and by talking about it, and if players have a little chant, they do.
I'm not physically there, but I'm there as much as I can be, and I'm cheering from my hospital bed or from my bed, wherever I am.
Alex dreamed of catching touchdown passes from Huskies quarterback Nick Shields in this, his first year of football, but instead, he's receiving chemotherapy treatment here at Swedish American Hospital. Doctors say there's about a 50-50 chance the leukemia will go into full remission, and Alex chooses to focus on the positive half.
If you're negative, then you're definitely not going to beat it. That's the way I look at it, and I've been positive at everything I've done through life.
I'm very proud of my son. I told him the other day he really puts me to shame because he's got so much more strength than I do on most occasions, and he's handling it exceptionally well.
I pretty much look at it as God picked somebody to have leukemia, and he gave it to me. So if he chose that it was me, that's fine, and I'm just going to have to beat it with his help and with a positive attitude.
because we haven't won for like so many years, and then finally we do. So I think it's awesome.
Song out of the- the main reason for tonight, I think you got to give Auburn a tremendous amount of credit. I thought Auburn came over here and played a great football game, played with great heart. They're a quality football team.
I just read them coming across the field, saw it, hoped he would throw it, and knew I had it all the way. It's great.
Football players are really excited about it. They're really pumped up about every game, and it makes it, like, we have, obviously, as you can see, we have a lot of fans that come now, and they're starting to, like, you know, get into the games more because we're winning a lot more. It's really fun.
Thank you. lot of people have said bad things about Harlem. They're like, oh, you're losing streak, you're not going to win. But it's our senior year, and it means a lot to us to go out with a bang.
Fans have turned out through all these losing seasons, and this year the fans are still with us, obviously.
At this point, the Knick 9 race is wide open. Who'd have thought Harlem would be right in the thick of it? Harlem fans, of course.
I hope they go all the way and make the playoffs and et cetera, because I think we deserve it.
It's been a wild and wonderful ride for the Harlem Huskies football team this year. They go into tonight's game 7-1 and could end up champions of the Knick 9 Conference. 1977 was the last time the school made it to the football playoffs, and just about everyone in the McChesney Park area is excited about it. Today, a special pregame meal and pep rally was held for the team to get them revved up.
And the kids, they've put a lot of time and effort into it, and by believing in them, it's really paid off. It's been very exciting for me to see all that hard work in the off season and this season come together, not only with the students, but also with the coaches.
Kevin Polke should know. He played linebacker for Harlem in the mid-80s when the team had major problems. Now he's a district social worker and serves as the team's strength coach. He believes the future for the football program is bright, no matter what the outcome of tonight's game.
If we continue the hard work and everyone sticks together, I think we can. This won't be a one-season deal.
Cheryl Eichmann believes in the team's future. She's been selling tickets for Harlem football games for 7 years. She says she's never seen this kind of enthusiasm before.
Well, I think it's great. I think we've waited a long time for this, and everybody is very proud of our football team.
And just about everybody would love to see a Harlem Husky victory tonight, especially the Husky players, who believe this will be a tough, hard-fought battle.
Oh, there's going to be some nice hits to be watching. It's going to be a good game to be at tonight.
My hands went numb. The kick went up and it was good, and that's it felt real good. My team supported me real good, and we're going to the playoffs. That's all I gotta say. It feels great. I just can't explain how great it really feels. It's the most wonderful feeling I've ever experienced. Feels great. It was a great game tonight. We came from behind, had a great kick at the end. It was a great game. Close game. They played great. We played a good second half. It was a good game.
Just making the playoffs isn't good enough, is it?
No, we're looking for far more better things than that. Our intensity level is so much higher than in past years. We're really looking forward to the playoffs because we know our execution is going to be there.
Unfortunately, in years past, it got to be a tradition over in Harlem that the day after football season was a day to turn in the jerseys. But this year, the Huskies are hoping that equipment manager doesn't have to take inventory until after Thanksgiving.
Peoria, Notre Dame, they're the 18th seed with a record of 8-1, and they'll take on number 15 seed, McChesney Park, Harlem, also 8-1.
This has been a party, but you guys just found out that you're playing Peoria, Notre Dame. All of a sudden, it's taken a little bit of a serious note down here, hasn't it?
Yeah, we're really excited because we've never been at this point ever before, and we've been looking forward to this point since 7th grade. We've always kept a positive mental attitude all the way through.
Players are all excited. We just found out the pairing, and it's pretty festive atmosphere, but now it's getting to game preparation. Now that we know what's going on, now we got to do our homework.
big one for 77 to put it on ice.
Yeah, well, I just saw the holes. Steve Ziske made a tremendous block up down the field, and that's how it happened. Steve Ziske.
Oh, you didn't have anything to do with it, huh?
Well, I mean, he had the block, and without him, I wouldn't have got in.
Let's talk about this ball game. You spot him, you know, two touchdowns, but then you come back and answer with four straight and take control of the game pretty much. I mean, you're back on top by halftime. A roller coaster today.
Yep. That's our team. We got heart. We got all it takes to win ball games. Yep.
Coach Benning said one thing I heard him say. Last year, you might have quit. What's the difference? Why didn't you quit this year? Why are you still playing when last year you wouldn't have been?
Well, this is the new Harlem. New and improved Harlem. That's what this is.
Yeah.